Now, with one of the lowest infant mortality rates in the world, we remember the man who saved the babies, the late Sir Frederick Truby King, the doctor who made life happier and healthier for countless mothers and their children.
Sir Truby King was born in April 1858. He was a sickly child, yet was hardworking and eager to learn. At the age of 22, he left New Zealand to embark on a career in medicine. He studied at Edinburgh University, where he completed a postgraduate medical degree in mental health. In 1887, King briefly became the superintendent of Wellington Hospital, before being appointed medical superintendent of Dunedin's Seacliff Mental Hospital, where he made many changes to improve the care of patients. In his late 40s, he began devoting his time to the care of infants. This passion originated with his endeavours to develop a healthy infant formula for his adopted daughter, Mary. He trained nurses at Seacliff in caring for infants and sent them off to Dunedin to advise new mothers. In May 1907, he addressed a crowd in Dunedin Town Hall about the health of women and infants. From this, the Society for the Promotion of Health of Women and Children was born. Plunkett focused on breastfeeding, training of nurses in maternal and infant welfare, and educating parents in domestic hygiene. Plunkett nurses visited mothers in their homes. In February 1938, he died in Wellington. He received many honours during his life, including a knighthood, and was the first private citizen in New Zealand to be honoured with a state funeral. Plunkett nurses are still making home visits and see more than 90% of New Zealand born children today. He captured the imagination of a young nation whose citizens were willing to care for their children.